Melbourne's train commuters know all too well the feeling of being stranded on a platform as peak hour services are delayed or cancelled, but few would have spared a thought for the men and women trying to deliver trains on time, sometimes against the odds. Tonight, Stateline gives you a new perspective on train travel, Connex and the City Loop, all from the driver's seat.
Hi, my name's Tim Perkis. I'm a Connex train driver. Today we're driving on the Frankston line. I've been on the job 27 years, driving 22, seen a lot of changes. It's a nice trip up from Frankston generally, going along beside the Nepean Highway. It's always nice to beat the cars. I like driving in the morning. Every now and again, you just wish you had a camera with you because sometimes the view is just sensational. The toughest thing about driving trains is level crossings and passing other trains on level crossings. That is the thing that tightens my chest, tightens my stomach. You never know who's going to come out from behind another train. All I'm doing is I'm ringing the FAT controller to tell him about the fault on the train so the train can be dealt with at a later stage. This is the perfect place for a station here, right next to Southland.
Yes.
They've never built one. They've never built a station here. Can't understand why, but obviously money and... Here we go. Wilson's light is on at all times, all seats.
Peak fault, reference 8166232,
peak fault. Yeah, no worries there. While I've got you there, Metro, running about 5 minutes down the account, isolated motors, they're over. Now they're starting to jam up. Let's see how everyone congregates around the doors.
Ladies and gentlemen, just move away from the doors as much as you can. We don't want to leave anyone behind if you can possibly help it, folks.
We've got all sorts of issues with congestion in close to Melbourne. When we have a number of trains converging on the City Loop at any one time, obviously only a certain number of trains can fit in there at any one time. That's where we come unstuck. You can run a train on time all the way in from Belgrave or Craigieburn or Sydenham, and then in the last couple of minutes all of a sudden you can lose 5 minutes and there goes your timetable. All we want to do is our job. And under sometimes it's under difficult circumstances. People walked up right up to my face and told me that Connex were less than they expected in stronger language. But you've just got to turn the other cheek and say, well, I'm sorry you feel like that, or have a nice day. Or but there is some aggression around. You just cope with it.
How long have you got?
It's loaded up. Busy day.
I'd like to think the worst is over as far as cancellations, delays and so on is concerned on the Connex network, but we can't predict the future. We're not clairvoyants. We'd like to think that we can improve our service, but I would suggest that well over 90% of the trains that I run are fairly close to time. I'm proud of that. I want to derive some job satisfaction from my job, so I can only do my best. Frankston? Okay, no worries, all done. We have a longevity in our job that is almost unknown these days. Because it's a job that most of us enjoy, we like being a part of Melbourne, really. Because we are a part of Melbourne, we're like it's like the milkman and it's like the like the garbos and like the tram drivers. Wonderful job. Like, we see so much in our job, we really do. I'm passionate about it, I love it.